All right, so welcome to episode number 9. Gonna start this off. We ended off the last episode with around 61 to 62 mil, which is a loss over the last episode. But the thing is, we have the stats we need now to do a lot of things, I feel like, in games. So now we're gonna focus a little more on money making. So I'm gonna be kind of contradictory here and say that we're going to start off with eclectics. I do have 46 more, so I should get about 2 mediums, hopefully. And, yeah, really just a fucking crapshoot, so we'll see how that goes. Alright, well, kill me, right? Went through all of them, did not get a medium clue, so that's a little disappointing, but, yeah, we'll figure out something else to do, though. Alright, so first little bit of money we made this episode, so gonna go ahead and sell off all of the malediction wards for pretty much 4198, I think is what we're looking at. That seems to be about the average. This would leave us with about a 200k profit off of each one, giving us a mil in total, which is pretty nice. From there, gonna go ahead and do some, that insta-sold, I think. Maybe, I don't know. Then again, gonna go ahead and once this Odium shard buys, go and do Odium wards. Once they're all done, I'm just going to keep the money, go get a Dragon Hunter crossbow, which I haven't used yet on this account, and I'm definitely willing to test out. I'm gonna go in the Wildy with a cannon and Dragon Hunter crossbow and just, kill some green drags, get some hard clue scrolls is probably the main plan. I am going to use a Ring of Wealth Eye, so hopefully we can get a few clues and go ahead and do that. Get ready for some rage in the next clip, just prepare yourself. Alright, usually pretty cool about all this shit, but goddamn, the fucking server disconnects are ridiculous. So, I was doing some Chaos Elemental, just trying to, you know, I'm going to make a video on it, just getting some kill times and stuff like that. Fucking, oh my god. So I lose my fire cape because I log in and stupid shit like this is happening where I cannot move at all. Upon login, I just can't move. And I saw Chaos Ellie coming towards me. I turned on my fucking protect item, but the thing is, like, it didn't matter. It didn't register anything, and I'm fucking pissed. Like, I usually don't get pissed at this, like, at the game for stuff that happens, but this is something that I can't control at all, and I feel so bad for any hardcore Iron Men that have died, because this is ridiculous. Like, yeah, so this whole thing makes me feel like a real piece of shit for not actually killing Jad on one of my tasks last week, because I went to go kill him, I was AFKing, and on wave 61, I fucking just died. I just died, because I was AFK, I was being an idiot, and now it just fucking, oh my god. Alright, here's a little bit of a post-com, just me showing you guys, me selling off my green dragon hides, and dragon bones, as you guys can see, sold off about 500 of each, and was able to buy 12,000 cannonballs. Alright, just finished off our Bloodfeld's task, however, was not able to get a superior, but we did get a hard clue, so gonna go ahead and do that, but first, 174 dags. Looking forward to that. Should be some good XP. Closing down strength level, kind of. Almost 90, which is actually a really good milestone. And as far as Slayer goes, we're progressing, you know. Alright, on to a couple of tasks. So Black Dragons, as you guys saw there, huge task. It allowed me to do some KBD, so I'm always happy with that. And then went and did some fishing beforehand. Also made 400k on each of these Odiums. And we are done with the task now. So went ahead and did... I don't know how many KBD kills I actually logged. I was with a group. I didn't plan on it, but they were just chilling there, so I figured I'd hang out with them. I was getting about the right amount of kills I should, but I was picking up half kills for getting the last hit. However, during these few kills, I was able to get 2 KBD heads, which is pretty cool. Got a U-log drop, and yeah, nothing too much to write home about. As you guys can see, only 35 bones, so. And time to get another task. 166 dags, we had that earlier. I think we had that task before this one. I mean, AFK and quick, so go ahead and do that. But, ooh, we are really close to that 90 strength level. So yeah, definitely gonna get that on this task. All right, so finishing up the medium clue that I got from the last dags task. Figured I'd do it before this next one started off. Actually, I think that's our most expensive one we've gotten yet. Morton clues and Ceridome Miter. We'll take that. Alright, here we go. We're gonna go ahead and get 90 strength. Shout out to this hoe. Saw dude. And just a couple more, you know, Slayer tasks. Just grinding it out. Got ourselves a clue scroll and nothing. Another task done. About to go do some homework down in the lab, so anything after this might not be recorded, but was doing some hellhounds, so that was pretty chill. And more Dagonauts every other goddamn task. Alright, so here's just a little bit of post-com for you guys. This is just going to be kind of a mashup of clips. I mean, for the most part, it is just farming and Slayer. Two things I've really been working on of late. I don't know. It's just kind of my thing. Like, farming's just something that I know is slow grind. I mean, it's not slow if you were to take, like, the time out of each time that you do it. But in the end, It's kind of something that you don't notice go up at all because you can only get so much XP a day. But as you guys saw there, there was a pretty useful clip in there, and that was when I got my Jad task again, so you guys will see that. But I made 1.3 mil on all these malediction wards, which is pretty sick. I think they insta-sold if I saw that right, which is pretty fucked. But as you guys can see here, I did almost die on Jad, and I almost died from the healers at the very end, so I could have gotten comboed out. But we got our fire cape back through that. Go on to do a couple more tasks as I do. Just like to go through these real quick, but I will say I do cancel every Kuras task. I don't care how efficient it is to do them, or if you guys think I should. I hate them. They have a ton of HP. It's a slow task, and I cannot be ass. So, back into the live commentary. Alright, so there we go. Showed you guys in the last little clip that I sold off a ton of Aram's robe skirts. So as you guys can see, sold those off for about a 55k profit on each, so around 300k in total. As you guys can see, there was one that wasn't actually sold off, and that's because I put it into an armor set that I sold off for 4.3 mil. If we go back through and add up how much I actually paid for it, I only ended up paying about 4.15 mil, so that's 150k profit off making it into a set, which was really nice, but yeah, I think this is something I'm just going to keep in here for a little while. I know it probably seems weird, but I'll go ahead and explain it now. So somebody recently made a, like, uncommon tips video or just, like, some crazy-ass shit with RuneScape, and it's a way to go ahead and go in the GE, buy out pretty much all the stock of one item, and then buy and sell an item for a really high margin and say that you, like, sold off one or whatever. But his example is with an Aram's hood, so I figure if anyone else tries to go ahead and copy that exact item, which would be idiotic to do so because of people like me that are doing this, then hopefully I can capitalize on that. All right, back to some post-com. How you guys doing? So this will be a little longer of a stretch, so I got you guys to myself for a little bit. But yeah, so just doing Slayer, per usual. If you guys saw there, I think I got Blue Dragon's task I decided to block. That's the first task that I have blocked on this account, but trust me, I have no regrets about that one. I hate Blue Dragons to no end. They are terrible. But yeah, as you guys can see, just random tasks rambling off here. I don't want to name each one because I don't feel like they have that much importance. But as you guys can see there, got some Odium wards to sell and made 1.6 mil off of all of them in total, which is pretty sick. Odium wards, just a constant moneymaker for me. And right there, another Jad task. Always excited to get one of them. And with shift click, you know damn well I'm going to be doing some fishing. So was chilling out for a little bit. I hate when people bring their herons, bro. Just because every time, I think it's mine. But as you guys can see, third KC at Jad. Going to go ahead and turn in the fire cape since I already have one done. And am I lucky? No, I'm not. But, you know, one day we'll get him to tell us that we're lucky. Got some Anku, finished those off, but you know, that's like the only task that I can justify my mind using a cannon for. Also, right here, while that is only one superior that you guys see here, if you guys look at my inventory right now, I have a full statue. That's because I got three superiors in this task. And if you guys see, I'm only at 77 KC. It was the craziest shit, like, just like one every 30 kills. I was so hyped, but I didn't get another one for the rest of the task, so let down a little bit, but I can't really be too upset, can I? So, from there it is. There's where I canceled Blue Dragons. I knew it was somewhere, man. I hate those things so much. Oh my god. They are terrible. So, a couple farming levels, but let's get back into the live com. Alright, first live com in a while, but we're about to go ahead and hit 73 fishing, which is pretty crazy. This actually marks a decent milestone, I would say, in this account. This is the first stat that actually has reached the level of my main account, so I have 73 fishing on my main, 73 on here. So, once I get 74, this will be the first stat to pass that account. I'm looking to just build this account, honestly. Like, we're almost at 1400 total, and I'm having fun, and there's still a lot of skills that I could get up pretty easily, like runecrafting, construction, hunter, thieving. Like, those are quick skills, so I'm feeling pretty good. Do have to get some mining up though at some point. Hey, they know damn well I want them ranger boots. Give me that clue, boy. There we go. Finally, just got back from Columbus, doing a little bit of late night fishing, and as I said in the last clip, this is the first stat that's higher than my main, so we got that going for us. Probably gonna go do something else now though, since kind of bored of fishing. Don't know if I made a mistake or not, but I went ahead and bought some Odium shards and whatnot. So as you guys can see here, in total I paid for the Odium Ward 2s, I guess I probably paid about 2.5 mil-ish on average, so we'll go with that. So in total I ended up spending about 5.3 mil on these Odium Wards. I believe, for each piece. Well, looks like I made the right decision. I guess it wasn't really a decision, but I'm going to go ahead and show you guys what I bought all of these for. So if we go ahead and look at them, as you guys can see right here, that's about 10.1 mil with this. So the Odium Shards 2 were 10.1. Then with the 3s in total, it was about 20.6. And then you add on the 1s. So that in total cost me about 21.3 mil, and these are selling right now for 6,700 each. So I'm gonna go ahead and sell these off right now. So I think I said 21.3 mil, and now we have 26.8. So making these made me a ton of money, but not from making them, more so just because I got lucky that these things shot up in price. And here we are, hit a pretty big milestone. So I ended up doing about, I think I started off with about 40 Ranar seeds, and this is what I got back from them. So I do have 4 still planted, so I don't actually have all of those, but I'm going to go ahead, sell them off. We're going to keep getting this Ranar supply going. I also have to talk to you guys about some of the stuff going on in my GE right now, but we'll get to that. Gonna go ahead, sell off all those, and then buy some Ranar seeds with this money. Alright, not gonna be an idiot and, you know, waste 1.8k whenever I buy all these seeds, because, you know, I could end up buying a ton more with that money. Or, I guess it probably saved me a couple seeds in all reality, but that's worth it to me. And so we'll be able to buy 83 Ranar seeds, pretty cool. And from there, gonna go and show you guys what I did with the Super Restores. So, there was a pretty big margin on them, and as you guys can see, I bought them for 6.67. I ended up pushing them into, I guess I didn't do this, but I put them into Super Restore 4s through the decant guy over there. So I bought that for 9.96 mil, and as you guys can see here, sold them for 10.46. So I made about 500k off that. Anku Top right now has a crazy margin on it. I'm going to try and get this margin for 1.2 mil. The last one that was insta-bought for 19.7, but I think that that's just a stray thing, and I could lose a couple hundred K on this, but I could get about a mil to 1.2 mil, so it's worth it to me. Well, first Venonatus kill of the night. We'll consider that a win. And here we go. Should be getting 92 strength right now, so that's a pretty big milestone. Halfway, technically, XP speaking-wise, to 99, which is pretty good. Combat level 102, so we're getting up there, but yeah, just going to keep grinding out strength, and 80k away from 81 Slayer, which is nice, so we'll keep working. And finished off the Bloodfeld's task, so gonna go ahead and grab another task. And Fire Giants, another good AFK task, always glad to get them. There we go, another task done, Fire Giants knocked out. We ended up getting a totem base, pretty cool I guess, and 170 Black Demons, that's a really AFK task, so. Made a little bit of unintended money, I guess. You guys can't really see what I bought these for, I guess now, but I bought this Malediction Shard 3 for 2.9 mil, so I actually made about 430k off that, which is cool. And then, as you actually can see here, I did end up selling off these Malediction Wards for about a 50k profit each, so. In total, about 500k-ish off of that. Gonna go make some Odium Wards in a second. There we go, was able to sell off some Odium Wards. As you guys can see, 18.8 mil here. Add on 6.3 for the other one that I don't have pictured here. So that brings us up to 25.1-ish. And I believe I paid about 23.6 for all these Odium Wards. So that's 1.5 mil profit. Speaking of 1.5 mil profit right now, Arcane Prayer Scrolls have a huge margin on them, so I'm going to go ahead, try to take advantage of that, and see if we can get one of these flips in before the end of the night. Alright, here we go. Oh, shit. Fuck, man. Damn. So, the Arcane Prayer Scroll about a couple hours ago was 40... It was about 48 mil or so, and I wasn't able to sell it on, but right now it is still 46.9 mil, so I'm hoping I can sell it on for that then. That still would be an insane margin, but I was hoping I could get this really, really big margin on it, so a little disappointed, as you guys could probably tell, but we'll be good. And medium clue, ready to go, and what I expected, nothing. And finished off another hard clue. Was kind of hoping that I wouldn't be able to finish it and that I'd have to finish a quest to kind of get this quest grind started today. But in the end, you know, I guess I was able to finish it, so it's pretty cool. Nothing really going on there. Probably your average clue. But as I did say a second ago, today is a day for quests, so look forward to that. I gotta get Barrow's Glove soon. I'm a level 102 without him, so I'm pretty much a noob. There we go. So what I've been talking about. Oh my god, 46.4 mil, as you guys can see right there. I was able to flip that item for 2.6 mil. That's insane. Gonna take a screenshot of that. That'll be in the thumbnail. But yeah, pretty excited about that. Going to go ahead, try to find some different merches, but definitely working on getting this bank value up. Little merch that I was up to, so in sold, Dragonhead seemed to have a big margin right now. And I bought around 1,000 pretty much for 11,800, as you can see right there. I ended up separating them into many different offers, as you can see, and changing them constantly. But then I was able to sell them all on for about a 600 GP profit. So we made about 600K off of selling all these, which is pretty good. And looking forward to trying to sell off more of them. These would actually be about a 350K profit only off of 500, so we're doing pretty good. And as promised, the quest grind has started. So just finished up dig site, got a mining level off of it, and also, as you guys can see here, sold off, or I guess ended up buying some insole dragon heads, making a ton of money off these things, so I'm hoping I can keep this going. All right, so as you guys can see, just non-stop profit coming in here. So I made about 700 to 750 coins each off of all these, so in total probably about 650K to 700 off of all this, and then as I said earlier, like about 700K there as well, like literally just a ton of money. And then I'm going to be able to sell off some more of these for, I think, 12,566 is what I'm going to try to sell them off for. I don't know if I can make more of those since these are all selling. Golem quest done pretty quick, to be honest with you, but yeah, there's that. Apparently I was supposed to pickpocket him, but we got that done, and as you guys can see in the chat, well, 32 thieving, which, you know, is what it is, but more importantly, got some more insold heads. Alright, so I know it's kind of a clusterfuck, but at this point I have sold off about 3,000 insold heads and made about 700 GP about-ish off of all of them, so that is really good. We probably made around 2 mil from merching all of these, and I'm going to go ahead and just keep on buying these if I can. So, I mean, they look like they have really good margins, and not a lot of people know what you actually can probably sell them off for, so I think I'm just going to go ahead and take advantage of this. I'm about to go get a haircut, so we'll see how many we can buy during that time. Just got back from a little jog. We may have a problem here, though. As you guys can see, I was able to buy all of my insold dragon heads, which you may think would be a good thing, but, I mean, realistically, I don't know what price they're down to now, so let's go ahead and check it out. I think someone else probably just dumped them, because I don't feel like there's any way the natural market let that many on me. Actually, that's not even that bad, so we're going to sell these all off, hopefully, for, I think it's 12,299. And if I go back and see how much I paid for all these, as you guys can see, I paid 11.8, which would mean that'd be a 500 GP off of all of them, making us 2 mil off of that. But we'll see. It'll probably take a little bit to sell that, I'd imagine. Alright, so decided to go for the quick instant profit. As you guys saw a second ago, I was merging them for, I think, 12.3, so I lost 99, it was actually 12.299, so I lost 99 coins times the 4,000. So I could have made another 400,000 off of slowly selling them. However, if I can insta-sell the rest of the 4,000, I'd definitely make more off of actually just buying them back for a lower price. So some dude was merging it for this low, I was willing to sell it. In total, we were able to make, as you guys can see down here, we were able to make about 400 GP off of each, a little bit over, which would mean we made about 1.6 mil on this alone. Today, in total, off of insold heads, it's probably around 3 mil, so yeah. Alright, so merging some insold heads right now. I may have lost a little bit of money on these dragon ones, but as far as most, or I guess some, of the insold demon heads, I was able to sell off for a 700 GP profit, probably gained us like maybe a little over 100K there. Well, just woke up and it seems like I've sold off most of what I was trying to sell. So with the insold dragon heads, I don't know if we can go back. Well, we can. That is good. I ended up making 180 off of all of these, so that got me a cool probably about 240-ish K. Well, more so around 300K actually. So I made about 300K on these, and then, as you can see here, I probably made about 600K off of these, which is really nice. So we got that all done. I'm going to go ahead and see if there's any more margins to be made on either of these heads. And yeah, as you guys can see, we are just raking in the cash at this point. All right, well, I just missed it because I thought I was recording, but just finished Garden of Tranquility. So that was a nice long little quest. But right now, I think I'm going to go ahead and get 60 farming. Just go on a quick farm run and show you guys kind of a money-making method I like to use on this account. But yeah, so right now we are merging off battle staffs. I'm actually happy they ended up starting to sell because they weren't originally. So got a 41 GP margin on all of the battle staff, so that is going to be a cool little 170K or so. So yeah, always on the merch grind. Yeah, miscalculated how much farming XP I was gonna get because one of the trees I had already checked its health. So yeah, I mean I would still would have been like 500 off, but I could get that on a farm run, like an herb run. But yeah, now I don't know what I'm gonna do. Probably just gonna buy some of the U seeds early, I guess. So something I have forgotten to do, or I guess really just pushed off to the back burner, was smithing. I'm going to go ahead and do Swan Song, and you need 45 smithing for that, so we're gonna go get that done. And we are done with that quest. So, tourist trap done, 2 quest points. I got about almost 10k agility XP for free, which is really nice, so now I'm gonna go ahead and get 45 smithing. Well, got that requirement out of the way, so 45 smithing is done. I think that just said something about like chasing gloves or some shit, but should be able to go ahead and do Swan Song now. Gonna wait for one of my friends to hop on, and we're probably gonna do that together. But for the time being, going to go ahead, probably do an herb run, and check out my GE offers. So, we just finished Gertrude's quest, I think, or Gertrude's cat, that is the name of it. Got ourselves a cat. I'm gonna grow it into a kitten, and then I think I'm gonna go and do a couple quests with one of my homies, Kevin. So, we're about to go probably do a little bit of a quest grind, I guess, but he's not on the mic right now, so I gotta wait. Done with another quest, not even gonna try to say that, but 2 quest points, Amulet Cat Speak, and realistically, I think I'm gonna go do rat catchers now, maybe? It seems like a terrible quest, but damn, we actually got, I think, a thieving or level or two there, maybe 3, and then an agility level, I'll take that. Another quest done, we got Mountain Daughter done, 2 quest points, and that 1 quest point, though. And now Soul's Bane will also be done, 1 quest point here, so nothing too much, but about to hit that defense level, which I don't want to hit because then it just, my stacks just look off, but whatever. And, yeah, good old 10-second quest here with Sheep Shearer. I don't know how it took me until this point to actually do it, but gonna knock that one out and, go do this one next. I think we're gonna do Rat Catchers. That's gonna be rough, but, yeah, that's on the list. We gotta do it at some point if I want to get that quest cape, so why not now? And that is the end of the free-to-play quest that I haven't done, up to 140 quest points, so moving closer towards Recipe for Disaster. And there we are, finished off Tears of Guthix. So another quest done, and let's see how much I can get. Like, let's see what Hunter level I can get. This is my first Hunter XP. Alright, 73 tiers, we'll take that. As you guys can see down there, I'm merching Eclectics. I have about a 50 to 60 GP margin on each, so trying to buy up a ton of them. But 1 to 7 Hunter, that's actually not bad. I might come here more often, because I know levels 1 through 20 Hunter are absolutely terrible. And I can still go to Varrock Museum, I think, too, so. So, there we go, 2 quest points, and the XP as you saw before. Also, 25k, bro, I'm fucking rich now. Let's go ball out of the GE. Alright, something that I haven't mentioned yet that I plan on doing is, well, that I am going to do and am doing right now. I'm merching Eclectic Implings, but what I'm doing is I'm just selling off exactly what they're worth. So, for example, I bought about almost 2,000 of them and sold them all off. But, as you guys can see, I bought 1980-ish. And I only sold on 1946. So basically what I did is whatever money I would have made by selling off the other Eclectics, I ended up keeping what my profit was. So in essence, I'm not making anything off of these merches other than the Eclectics that I keep. So that's what I'm working on right now. Just kind of want to stash up a ton and do some medium clues. But yeah, there we go. And I believe this is where we are going to end off the video, guys. So I am currently merching some Eclectics. Oh, man. And as you guys can see right here, I have 2.6 mil that I'm going to go ahead and take out. And if we go ahead and remember this, I have 38.5 mil currently on that offer. So what I'm going to do right now, bank everything as I usually do and go ahead and use Conduit to find out what my total bank value is worth. So that'll be up on screen here in a second. All right, so this is pretty much the best way I figured I could go through this. So we're going to go to bank value, calculate, and boom, 51 mil. So going to go back over here now. So as you guys saw, 51 mil right there, and on top of the 38.5 that we have over here, brings us up to a total of, that's actually 90 mil. So our bank is up to 90 mil. That's a lot of progress this episode. I feel like merching really helped me a lot. That arcane prayer scroll, I still can't believe how good of a margin I got on that. But that'll be the end of episode number 9. Hope you guys enjoyed. If you guys did, make sure to leave a like. Any improvements you guys have, go ahead and leave them in the comments down below, or any suggestions you got. And as always, make sure to subscribe and hit up the Twitter link in the description. Nonetheless, with that being said, hope you guys have a wonderful day, and peace. And what the fuck? Someone just sold off 10,000 fucking eclectics?